One of my first experiences as a gamer was playing Ratchet and Clank for the PS2 with my mom and dad when I was a kiddo of 4 years old. I really loved that game back then. Fast forward to 2016, where after releasing countless sequels and spin-offs, the creators Insomniac Games decided to go back to their roots by creating a remake of the original based on the 2016 Ratchet and Clank movie. It features the good old third-person shooter formula with a healthy dose of crazy weapons, bright environments, and the insane humor it's known for. In Ratchet and Clank, you play as a young mechanic called Ratchet, who wants to join a team of intergalactic superheroes called the Galactic Rangers with his best buddy Clank. After making a few questionable choices influenced by his questionable mentor, Captain Quark, Ratchet tries to save the galaxy from evil political power Chairman Drek and mad scientist Dr. Nefarious. The narrative follows a tried and tested formula that can get a bit repetitive at times. You even question the character's choices sometimes. However, the large amount of humor makes up for it. The atmosphere during gameplay is great, with characters talking to you a lot and can lead to a lot of funny interactions with them. Unfortunately, the characters appear quite lifeless in the cutscenes. I personally didn't enjoy the story much, as I found it hard to empathize with the characters, but there's no doubt that it leads to a lot of funny moments. The climax is a story of redemption, where Quark finally decides to do the right thing after briefly siding with the villains for a while. Ratchet also learns to look before he leaps, or rather, shoots. The game starts with a short tutorial segment where Ratchet is taking part in the Galactic Ranger tryouts. He gets rejected and goes back home. Shortly after, he notices something falling from the sky. He goes to explore and finds a small robot who he nicknames Clank. After that, they go in their ship to planet Kerwan, where an attack is going on. They save the planet and get a place in the Galactic Rangers. Afterwards, the dynamic duo go on to save the galaxy. Gameplay is varied but mostly based around playing as Ratchet, which involves platforming segments with fast-paced shooting segments where you have to clear out a certain number of enemies before progressing. There are also some stealth sections where you masquerade as Captain Quark. There's also space dogfighting, which is an absolute blast, but gets over quickly. I want more spaceships! Clank is also playable with puzzle segments involving tiny catchbots. They can help you reach new heights, create bridges, or power devices. Some of the puzzles are pretty hard. Even with my brain, I struggled on some of them. The best part is they are logic puzzles. You don't need to learn any fancy mechanics. There are also side quests involving hoverboard racing, which are quite tough. Jetpacks also appear in some exhilarating aerial combat sections. In addition to that, you can find collectibles scattered all over the galaxy like gold bolts, card packs, and extra gadgets. You can find cards in hidden places or obtain them as rewards for certain missions. They contain bits of Ratchet and Clank history all the way back from 2002. They usually contain some funny descriptions. The enemy designs are varied as well, from slimy green creatures and desert frogs to robot henchmen and tanks. And now to the weapons. Oh, the weapons! They are simply amazing and the centerpiece of the game. These aren't your regular sniper rifle, pistol, machine gun type weapons. They are amazingly creative and mostly overpowered. For instance, the Groovitron, which makes all enemies on the screen do an entirely unique dance. No Fortnite dances though. Then there's the self-explanatory Sheepinator, which is really fun to use. And don't even get me started on the Rhino, which plays orchestral music in the background while unleashing a volley of missiles with a crazy rate of fire. And then there's the Pixelizer, which restores all the enemies to their former 8-bit glory. Even the more generic weapons like the Pyrocyter, which is a flamethrower, are over the top. And the fusion bomb is a blast to use, pun entirely intended. The graphics in Ratchet and Clank are absolutely beautiful. The environments are rich and vibrant. Planets like Novalis are lush and beautiful, and Gaspar feels like a hot volcanic planet, which it is. There's also a vast diversity in the locations you visit, from snowy to volcanic, natural to mechanical, populated to desolate. Each and every location feels unique. The planets are all vivid and seem active, like there's life to them. The game runs at 1080p 30 frames per second, which is solid for the PS4. The frame rate is a bit jarring though, as most games run at 60fps. However, the cutscenes which aren't ripped straight from the movie definitely feel a bit dull and lifeless, mainly due to the game getting rushed. It can look a little unpleasant, and there's a lot of these cutscenes. Since Ratchet is normally an active guy, it just doesn't look right with him and the other characters just standing. You're probably thinking I'm biased, but the majority of the story in a game is told through cutscenes, so it's kind of a big deal. The music in the game is fairly good, with the music suiting for every location. However, most of the music is just orchestral and doesn't feel very sci-fi. The melodies aren't memorable either. However, the voice actors have done a fantastic job with the lines, and they really suit each character. James Arnold Taylor and David Kaye are back as Ratchet and Clank respectively, and Jim Ward does really well as Captain Quark. The support characters are voiced really well too. In conclusion, gameplay in Ratchet and Clank is really fun and diverse, with the presentation being really good. However, the rushed cutscenes, uninspired story, and bland music might be a deal breaker for some.